Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. If you're someone who finishes productions in Flame, it is most likely you've been faced with multiple versions of the same media coming from a variety of external sources. So you would start off with the original camera media, but then you could get a version of the media with VFX compositing, and perhaps other versions of the same media with a variety of grading, etc. The point being is that this same media can evolve with third-party applications, and you can land up with multiple variations of the same media. Now, as you work and develop the production, all these different versions need to be tracked within Flame. This is not quite different from working in a CGI pipeline, where you could be given different stages of CG, such as previs, animatics, work in progress, and final renders. The expectation is for you to constantly update your timeline and maintain the latest version of each shot. This could further be expanded to render passes and multiple versions of render passes. In both situations, Autodesk has been developing the OpenClip workflow to manage all these incoming versions, and you are in total control of updating and choosing what you see within the Flame products. Now, the basis of the OpenClip workflow uses a series of XML files known surprisingly as OpenClips. These small text files with a .clip extension can hold a wealth of information, including pointers to multi-channel media, multi-version media, and more. This technology has been in the Flame products for many years and is used very successfully. However, in previous versions of Flame, there were only two ways to create OpenClips to manage media versioning. This either involved publishing your sequence out of Flame and re-importing it back into Flame, which is not considered a fun and effective task. Or you could manually script your own OpenClips, since they are an XML-based text-based format, but you'd have to invest the time and resources to get it to work. Some facilities have even automated this process using some clever custom scripting. So this works amazingly well, but the setup and implementation wasn't right for everyone. Fast forwarding to the Flame 2018.2 update, a concentrated effort has been made to the OpenClip workflow to make it accessible to everyone at all skill levels. So here is a quick summary of the enhancements. Firstly, the new OpenClip creator has been introduced at the import level within the Flame products, and this makes it easier to start using the OpenClip workflow without too much effort. So you can create OpenClip XML files that are properly configured to your media, and you don't need to know anything about scripting. As new versions come up, you can update the OpenClips without having to leave the Flame products. Secondly, the OpenClip creator is also accessible from outside of the Flame products. So in the context of working in a production, you can have someone generating the OpenClips who does not need to know Flame or even take up valuable finishing time. This person could be a data manager, prep assistant, or even a runner. They can just launch the toolset and start creating OpenClips for you. These tools can also be executed via a command line, and this can be automated through scripting, as well as integrating OpenClip creation within production management tools like Shotgun, etc. And thirdly, another enhancement is to use strings and pattern recognition within OpenClips. This is slightly more advanced than just selecting clips, but this allows you to use OpenClips as placeholders. As soon as media or a new version becomes available, it automatically becomes available in Flame. This is quite an amazing versioning up feature and something worth checking out. So in summary, the OpenClip workflow allows you to monitor, maintain, and version any external media within your production pipeline. The Flame products can create OpenClips on import or generate OpenClips on export. There is now also the possibility to generate OpenClips outside of Flame with the OpenClip creator or command line tools. this can open a whole lot of possibilities within your production pipeline. And finally, for those flame artists that use the powerful Connected Conform feature set, open clips are treated the same as regular media. The only difference is that you can monitor, version, and update your media within all the sequences used within the Connected Conform. In the next few videos on the open clip workflow, you'll run through the open clip creation process, starting with importing media into Flame. Don't forget to also check out the other enhancements, workflows, and features to the Flame 2018.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.